Hey everybody, this is Nick, and today I'm going to show you how to make this really interesting slide with a video background inside of text. Now, we have made videos like this where we have worked with the merge shapes tools to subtract text from a shape and then put a video background behind the scenes. You could absolutely do that trick here, but I wanted to try a different trick that I've been seeing online, but I couldn't quite figure it out. And there is a trick to it that I think PowerPoint needs to fix. So PowerPoint, if you are listening to me, I hope that we fix this pretty soon. I'm going to escape out of this slide and I'm show you what I mean. I'm going to make this slide from scratch here. The first thing we need to do is insert a video. So go to the insert tab, go to the video button over here and say from stock video, I'm going to go ahead and search Earth. Here's that video that I had right here. Let's go ahead and insert it. It's a nice full page or full slide video. I actually want to rotate it because I want my text to be on the left side. So what I'm going to do is click on the video, go to the video format tab, click on rotate, and then rotate this horizontally. And then what we're going to do is put some text on top. So let's go ahead and insert a text box right here. I'm just going to put it across the whole slide. I'm going to put my all caps on and say planet Earth. And then we're going to have to just edit the text, change it to white, and start playing with the size. Let's make it really, really big so that it fills that slide. What I think I want to do is change the line spacing to maybe 0.8 here, make it a little tighter. And then what we'll do is we'll do an extra bold font that looks so nice. This actually looks like a pretty cool slide, I think, as it is. If you just wanted to use this slide just like this with the video of Earth moving in the background, it would look really cool. So now in order to get that video inside that text, here's the trick. Now, normally what we would do if this was a shape and not a video, or a picture, we would click that video, hold down shift key, hold down the text, and usually the format shape menu pops up and we would work with the merge shapes tools. But we don't have that here in this, as you see on my ribbon, when I select that video, nothing pops up. Even when I just select the video format tab pops up, but I don't have any of those merge shapes tools along my ribbon here. So let's go ahead and do this again one more time. Select the video first, then select the text. Make sure both are selected, so hold down shift while you do that. Now what we need to do in the search bar is search for merge shapes. And you can see that since I already did this once, it popped up for me. But we're going to do this, and as soon as merge shapes pops up here, hover over it, and all of your merge shapes tools magically appear on this menu. And so what you're going to do then is you're going to go down to intersect, click, and now your video is intersected with that text. You need to go ahead, go to the video format tab, and then go to the playback tab. And instead of when clicked on, let's say automatically, we want this video to play automatically when we put it in slideshow mode, and we're gonna loop it until stopped, because maybe this will be like an introduction slide and people are coming in to my audience while this slide is running. And now all we need to do is put this in slideshow mode and watch it run. This is a beautiful slide. What a cool trick. And I can't believe you have to do that little workaround to search for merge shapes in that search bar while you do it. I knew that this was possible because I've seen a bunch of people on YouTube doing it. And this just took a little bit of clicking and I finally found out how. So congratulations to all of us. And thank you to everybody on YouTube who's posted videos like this. I think this is such a fun slide effect. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you. I hope you had a great time watching, and I can't wait to see you all next time.